Apologies, y'all. We're back. Music should be going. Everything should be back up and running. Sorry. We're only going to need about that much onion. Oh, well, that was irritating. And then we need about 3/4 cup of white wine vinegar. Which I've had this for a little bit, but it'll be fine. Haven't even opened it. It's still good until April of 2024. We're golden. Do is we're going to bring this to a boil, and it's just going to be a quick estimate of about 3/4 cup. And then we're going to reduce the heat and simmer it. Always fun when my laptop goes out. Apologies, y'all. Okay, let me grab a baggie. Grab a baggie for both the peppers and the onion. These will be good as snacks, nice and crispy peppers. We'll throw some onion and some stuff later. All right, so these are the hoagies. I might do these in a pan on the stove. I'm not sure. But what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and slice them in half. Got my bread knife here. And then we'll toast these. Alright, we've got the hoagies all nice and sliced. A little bit longer there before I reduce that heat, and then we'll just let it simmer for a bit. We do want to get some butter on these. I don't think this got warm enough, but that's okay. Actually, it did. That is a timer on the chicken. We'll need to let that probably go another 3 minutes. I may just go ahead and broil these real quick in the oven. Plenty of butter on them, though. Going pretty thin on these slices, though. Since we've already got it at 450, we can probably just go ahead and go up from there. Because we do want to get these toasted so that they retain all that, help creates a barrier for the moisture from the peppers and the chicken. And so it'll just give it a nice toasty finish here. I'm having all sorts of trouble tonight. Doesn't have to be complete. I might put some garlic salt on these just to give them some flavor. Make it a garlicky bread. Time to check this chicken again. All right, that's probably the last extension on the chicken. Yeah, nothing like butter. Okay. This chicken is probably ready to go. I'm gonna have to probably do these in a couple batches. These are going to go very, very, very quick. Get anything I needed? I don't think I did. Oh, probably a little bit of salt. That's okay. I don't usually condone this, but we're gonna have to cut into this and make sure that these are done. They are not. What's up, Crushers? How you doing? I need to get this chicken back in the oven. Just leaving the gym? Nice. I don't want these rolls to go too far. But I also need to get them out as soon as possible so I can get the chicken back in. We're gonna have to probably let the chicken go another, you gotta lose like 60-ish pounds before April 7th. Are you in a weight loss competition? or traveling and want to be in tip-top shape. That's when you go to Japan, so both. Oh, nice! Japan will be fun. I'm jealous that you're going to Japan this year. I want to go, but not going to happen anytime soon. I had originally planned on going this year, but it's just not going to happen. I need to let that cook down for a little bit. These are nice and toasted. Once the chicken's done, after it's had more time to cook, I'll go ahead and plop the others on. And we'll get them under the broiler as well. Get some more garlic salt on here. So the nice thing is this is going to be a high protein sandwich. With lots of peppers. I need that to cook down a bit more. Oh. There, that's starting to simmer a bit more. Then what I'm going to do is I will pulse the peppers up in here. And that'll give us a nice paste. I'll throw it into a container. And then we can start putting it on the sandwiches. We'll get the chicken sliced up. I'm going to put the provolone down on top of that. May put the provolone down on the bottom. Well, that's good for you, Crushers. I'm glad to hear you've got a goal set, and it's a good goal to have. I need to do that myself. Want a lot of gym buddies. You know, that would be really functional if I had a gym membership. I do not. You won't look too much in the changing rooms. There it is. One of these is for me. I have 7 more slices, but I love provolone cheese. There's 8 slices in here, but I want one for me. It's actually gotten really warm. It's like 8 degrees or so. That's a pretty big change compared to what it's been the last few days. Yeah, we're supposed to start getting snow tomorrow. I checked the forecast. I was off by a day. I was thinking it was today. But no, it's tomorrow. I don't want this chicken to dry out, but also I don't want to take it out too soon. So we're just waiting patiently. I think the chicken's been in for like 28 minutes, and I was thinking it would only take 15 to 20. How far under zero are you? You were quite a ways under, weren't you? Oh, nice. It was like 21 under. Cocktails are always fun. I'm trying to figure out a whether I wanted to start doing cocktails or if I want to just rely on somebody else, because like I just drink Knob Creek or I drink whiskey on the rocks. I don't do much for cocktails. I'll do old fashions. Felt like 4,500. Good Lord. I don't know what I would do with my dog. We were at, felt like 20 under the other day, and it was really, really dangerous for her to be out because she's so small. Gonna wait till you're fit, though, because of calories? Yeah, I totally get that. I couldn't imagine trying to deal with her and 45 under. Yeah, she's got a jacket that she wears, and I have boots that came in today for her. She won't wear them. I tried. She won't wear them, and it's going to be interesting. I'm going to try for another day or two. If she doesn't want to put them on, I'll send them back. You have a malt? Oh, nice. Maltese Shih Tzu. Oof. That's such a small dog to have outside, especially in that weather. Much better. They have pull strings. Okay, interesting. So part of Roxy's problem is she broke her paw a couple years ago. And so she had to wear a splint on her paw and on her leg that kept her from really walking around and moving. So she doesn't like having her paws touched anymore, especially anything around them. So that's why I'm hesitant. I can keep trying with her for a couple more days. But I don't want to push her too much. Assuming I can put hot liquids in here. We'll find out. This might get loud for a second. But it's usually pretty quiet. I need to get these last ones in here. All right. Was that an AOL sound? Indeed it was. My text message tone. But yeah, that's my text message tone. So that's gonna, as it cools, actually I'm gonna chill that real quick in the freezer. As that chills, it should continuing, I can't pronounce that, apologies. Welcome, thank you for the follow. All right, that's gonna only take another couple minutes. Let's check this chicken here. Oh yeah, perfectly done through the middle. Look at how perfectly cooked that chicken is, y'all. Good flavor. Nice and juicy. Yeah, that's looking good. Whew. Those are ready to come out. What's up, Mario? Ones are a little toastier. A little bit too far, but that's okay. Oh. All right, let's move some of these off of here. Definitely toasty. All right. Now I need to clean that up. I unfortunately don't have a very big kitchen. Crushers with the innuendos again. I guess it's Marlo, not Mario. Apologies. I kept seeing the L as an I. Everyone does it. I'm glad I'm not alone. All right, so what I want to do thickened up quite nicely. So let's do the first one here. We want to put a layer of Kewpie mayo down. We're going to take some of this chicken. We're going to layer it nicely across here. What I want to do. Oh, crushers. All right, so we're gonna put a little bit of that on. What did I do with the cheese? I just had it. It's right here. Put a little bit of the provolone down. And then we'll take some of our mixture, or our pepper relish. I'll go ahead and spread that over. We got some pepper relish. And there is our sandwich. Grab my saran wrap out of the drawer here. We'll wrap it up in saran wrap. We'll be right back. our first one done. We're just going to repeat this step a few more times. All right, looks like we got about 45 seconds left in the ad. And welcome back, everybody. Go ahead and get some more saran wrap out here. So we've got two sandwiches made, and I haven't even used the whole first chicken breast, which I'm gonna have plenty of chicken for sandwiches, for all sorts of stuff. So we're just putting a thin layer of the pepper relish on each one of these. Just a little thin layer of that. Plenty of chicken. So I'm just using a can of roasted red peppers, or a jar of them, not a can. That was fun, drop some of them there. I could probably move this more into view so you can see what I'm doing. But it's just the same process over and over. Optical Gurney, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. Welcome to the community. Hope you enjoy your stay. And we've got another sandwich there ready to go. Now I'm just kind of just eating chunks. Oh. I really need to get better knives. That's on my list to buy. I just sharpened this yesterday, and it's already not holding an edge. We'll get there. We'll get him. That's twice I've dropped a red pepper. My bed frame came in and my hands are just sore as can be, and I don't know why. From assembly, and they shouldn't be. But it is what it is. That also is probably due to the dexterity issues I have. due to carpal tunnel. Just not a good combination. Apparently I cannot keep this saran wrap from tangling up on itself tonight. Slice up some more chicken here. It just becomes a repeatable process. Over and over. And then once we're done on this last one, I'll make it for tonight to actually eat. I think I'm going to save this one for now. I'll do this one wrapped up. So this is the last one we're going to make. I will be eating one of these sandwiches. Crushers. What are we gonna do with you? Send you one of the sandwiches? If I could, I would. You better hurry back, because I'm about finished here, Crushers. Alright, so now I've got all of mine prepped. Hey, Big Sam the Ham, thank you so much for the 2 months subscription. I appreciate it. So there, got the chicken and the red pepper and the provolone. Had some gumbo tonight since it was getting cold, so cold down here. Nice. We just finished meal prepping my sandwiches for the remainder of the week. I have 5 more sandwiches left, lots of chicken left. I'm going to use that on salads, whatever. I'll dice it all up, have it ready to go. But yeah, that's good. So we've got mayo, chicken, red bell pepper, provolone, and then the pepper relish that we did on the top. Let's go ahead and take a bite of this. I might eat 2 of these tonight. Oh man. The vinegar from the pepper relish comes through and it just, so good, so good. Oh man. And it just cuts through. And you get that roasted red pepper, the sweetness from that. The herbs that were crusted on the chicken, perfect. Chicken is super juicy. And the provolone is just perfect. You could also do mozzarella if you don't like provolone. Y'all, that sandwich. And the sweetness of the peppers. It just... So good. I'm gonna go pick up some more hoagies tomorrow. As you can see, I've got lots of chicken back here. I have lots of bell pepper and lots of the relish as well. Oh. What is my favorite cheese? So it depends on context. Depends on what I'm doing with it. I'm a really big fan of aged, extra sharp white cheddar. When you pair it, you get the saltiness from the I age my own, so I'll buy it at, you know, a year aged, and then I will keep it in cold storage and age it for another 3 or 4 years and get that really good briny, salty deliciousness. But then, you know, a good smoked Gouda or Howdah, depending on where you hail from. Munster is really good on a sandwich. There's a spot here in town that has a horseradish Havarti and a horseradish. They also have a horseradish cheddar that is really good. I use those on sandwiches a lot. Munster is fantastic. I like smoked Gruyere I'll use it on pizzas. It just really depends on what I'm doing with it. Like I made the pasta a week or so ago. I love blue cheese. I mean, that a really strong blue cheese is really, really good in my book. I like goat cheese around Christmas time. Serve that up with crackers. I do my own jalapeno and raspberry or jalapeno and blackberry preserve that I'll do, or a jam that I'll do for making with baked brie. So you get that sweet and spicy with that savory brie cheese. I love cheese. I eat too much of it. It does not like me, but I love cheese. If I'm making a sandwich, if I'm making just a turkey sandwich or roast beef or anything like that, a lot of times I'll just go with pepper jack. Pepper jack is a fantastic cheese. You get that jack cheese mixed with the hot peppers. Washington State University, obviously I went to school there, so I'm a little biased. They have the WSU Creamery, and they have what's called Crimson Fire. It is this creamy, fantastic, hot and spicy jack cheese. It's fantastic. They're also the same one. All of theirs come in cans, which is why I can actually age them longer. Those are the ones that I age. The Cougar Gold cheese is what I will age. So there's lots of options, lots of really good cheeses out there. Again, mostly depends on what I'm doing. Velveeta is fantastic if you're making it in like a dip, honestly. You know, people give Velveeta a hard time, and it's not the best thing in the world for you, but it's no different than Kraft Singles. They're highly processed, but they're still cheese. They just are able to melt easier. So, I mean, it really just kind of depends on what you're doing with it. All over the board for me, I eat. If it's cheese, I'll eat it. I'm eating another one of these. This is what I didn't do, was I didn't take a picture. Queso fresco is really good. Cotija is nice and salty and crumbly and delicious on top of a taco. Or on top of a salad. I'll do elote salad. I'll do an elote style salad with, and then serve that over roasted chicken with some cotija and a cilantro lime dressing. Some fresh red onion and tomato. I mean, it adds to that flavor. Oh, this is so good. I forgot to eat earlier today too, so this works out well. I had a bar like an hour ago or 2 hours ago, and I forgot breakfast, forgot lunch. I just got to working and forgot. So, yeah, if you're looking for a delicious sandwich, highly recommend this one. I did not use mustard seed, so you can actually leave that out. Sometimes I'll put it in this. I actually almost think I like this better without the mustard. So if you go to make it, leave out the mustard. It is so, so good this way. And then just literally a jar of roasted red pepper strips, a few pounds of chicken, this is a cilantro infused olive oil. Doesn't really add much to the flavor of the food, but it still is really good olive oil. And then just a nice soft hoagie. And I use Kewpie mayo because I love the taste of Kewpie mayo. Oh, so good. But yeah, let's go ahead and see if we can find somebody to send you to. I appreciate you guys hanging out. This is probably this is one of my top things to prep. Are these sandwiches. I like to do first time I've done this one. I've made similar sandwiches before, but I haven't made this one before. So this one was I'm liking this. I've made the relish before, but again, I left out the mayo or left out the have I ever made a sandwich with Mexican crema? I have made I'm trying to think. I don't know that I have. I have not made my own tortas. I go to a place here in town that I absolutely love tortas. They do an amazing job with theirs. Try it sometime around hot dogs. Okay. All right, let me see who we can send you to. They're great with crema. Okay. Bianca's birthday is coming up. Let's see. Who haven't we rated lately? Oh, Janine Stream. She's back from Taiwan. So let's go ahead and go say hello to her. Thank you all so much for hanging out tonight. Make sure you copy that rate command. And I will see you guys probably this weekend. Have a good night, y'all.